Welcome to Nan's Kitchen. Today we are going to make baked Mexican chayote. It's a dish that was taught to me by my university mate Mariana. She made it for me many years ago during Christmas and I found it very delicious and unique, and I'd like to share with you all today. Many people have not heard of chayote. It is a gourd fruit that was one of the seven foods brought to the old world during the Columbus Exchange during Christopher Columbus era. Chayote could be eaten either cooked or raw. In Chinese, this is called he zang gua, which means two palms coming together. It's very romantic. It's a very sweet and light fruit, and the texture is kind of similar to potato or cucumber. Let's get cooking. Let's start by cutting the chayote in half. Inside you'll see the seed as well. That's actually the sweetest part of the fruit. Everything else, you just want to dice it up. Add salt to the water, salt it heavily like the ocean, and then we're going to add in our fruits. I also have the leftover chicken bone, just add it in. You can actually drink this as well for a soup if you wanted to as well, so that's some extra food there. Afterwards, let it cook until it's soft enough you can cut a knife through. We're going to add extra virgin olive oil, this is 1 to 2 tablespoons. We'll cook is the potato because that takes the longest to cook.
Season with salt and pepper. Cover with the lid to let it cook and add some broth to let it steam. Add a frozen block of caramelized onions. It's nutty and sweet and adds a lot of complexity to your dish. A tip is I buy a 10-pound bag of onions for $1.97 this summer, caramelize, then freeze them, and I can throw them in whenever I'm feeling fancy. Season with salt, pepper, paprika, and cumin.
Let's kick it!
I like to add my garlic later so it doesn't burn. Cover with a lid and cook until softened. Always taste and season your food as you go. So far it tastes pretty good.
I'll cut the chayote innards. Just cut it in a circle.
Add the red peppers and cilantro last to retain its bright colors. At this point, everything should be well caramelized and have an earthy, nutty, and spicy aroma. Scoop the filling into the chayote cups. You can add Manchego or pepper jack cheese on top. I didn't, as my parents hate cheese. They're missing out on the Gouda life. Was that too cheesy? Bake at 350 degrees for 20 minutes.
Thankfully, I tried to pick my battles till the battle picked me. Misery, like the war of words I shouted in my sleep.